Thank you very much. I'm here to talk about music as precision medicine. And while we're here at Tech Open Air, it's been a remarkable but also hectic day. I'd like to just start with 2 minutes of listening to music. This is Berlin-based Max Richter, remarkable record on Vivaldi's Four Seasons Recomposed. And please take this moment just to reflect and form the intentions for the day. Here we go. Please remember this URL, I will come back to it. What we're doing at Sync Project, which is a biotechnology company based in Boston, is developing music as precision medicine, and by precision, we here mean personalized to each individual. Music is a remarkable thing. We all self-medicate with music in some way. We use music to get pumped up, to relax, to calm us down, to work out. And so we intuitively, we know this. In addition to that, there is mounting scientific evidence and directional evidence about the health effects of music, and this is of two kinds. There's more fundamental understanding of the neurological basis of music listening, so what is firing in the brain when we listen to music. Broadly speaking, we know that music fires similarly to some regions and networks in the brain as pharmaceuticals, i.e. drugs. This would say that it is in principle possible that with using music, you could complement or replace certain pharmaceuticals. And that's the main theme here, is to use non-pharmacological, non-drug ways, non-chemical ways to achieve drug-like outcomes. Music fires regions related to emotion, motivation, reward, and pain, the dopaminergic circuitry, stress, arousal, autonomic responses, as well as strong social affiliation. There's also directional clinical evidence about the health effects of music. We know that music is used for physical exercise, but perhaps surprisingly, it's been shown in studies that playing music can decrease perceived pain. So playing music to patients after an operation objectively leads to less self-administered opioids, analgesics, or morphine. And given the kind of opioid epidemic in the United States, Prince just died of an opioid overdose. If you could show that using correctly tailored, tuned music, a playlist effectively tuned to your body, to decrease the amount of opioids that are needed, that's a remarkable thing. Now, why is it possible to develop music as a precision medicine now? Well, many things have changed, and some trends are pointing in the right direction. First of all, we all have a celestial jukebox of all the music in the world, pretty much in our pockets in the form of streaming services on smartphones. We have explosive growth of biometric sensors, and machine learning essentially is a cloud utility, so you don't need to build the infrastructures to do the analysis of the data set. Now, while there's strong intuitive sense, we all self-medicate, we know that, there's strong directional evidence, there isn't a single condition that stands out that you could absolutely go after that condition and build therapies only for that. Instead, what we've decided to do is to build a platform to map music characteristics to the biometric effects on an individual level. What does music characteristic mean? Characteristics mean? That's beat, the depth of a groove, clarity of the rhythm in music, the key, sequence of harmony, as well as then timbre or color, the instruments used. So we machine analyze the music, its structural properties, and then using biometric sensors attached to smartphones, we can track the biometric impact on an individual level. And then on this data set, we apply machine learning to deliver personalized music therapeutics, to uncover these personalized music signatures. Now, the conditions we are going after initially are the ones where the directional evidence in the science and willingness to adopt non-pharmacological means are strongest. They include sleep, stress, anxiety, relaxation being the flip side of that, pain, as I just mentioned, and then movement disorders. We know that music not only moves us, it makes us move, and it's well known that music has been used, or actually rhythm or metronomes have been used in treating Parkinson's patients when they freeze and are unable to initiate gait. So playing a music stimulus essentially re-allows a person to start walking. So we're applying that. The flip side of that is athletic performance, high-intensity interval training, where the right kind of music can be used to keep you in the zone and take you down in the zone, so to increase the effectiveness of training. Now, how are we gathering this data set? I wanted to say a little bit about this. Is we collect data across scales. We've been doing it quietly for the last year. We've analyzed over 10 million playlists where people have tagged a playlist with a health-related term, like sleep or relaxation. And we analyze those acoustically. What are the properties that are typical of songs like that? On the other end, we've started small and more focused, even clinical studies, where we have some sense of a control. So what instead of music, is it listening to an audiobook that we compare the effect sizes to? Here, the number of participants are in the tens to the hundreds. We're also launching later this year a mobile application which will be open for anyone to contribute, and we'll use in-phone sensors to track movement, as well as sensors like this ring that tracks sleep very accurately, different smartwatches to gather data on a selected range of experiments. Finally, and what I want to come back to that URL, is we're very, very grateful. Almost daily, we receive messages from people around the world saying, I'm interested in the health effects of music, how can I contribute? And we wanted to give some sort of channel for that, even if you're not, don't have a biometric sensor yet, but you know that something has worked for you. So we've started just today with a goal of collecting 1 million songs that have worked for people. This is self-authentic, thoughtful self-report. People saying what functionally they have used music for. We're starting with relaxation, sleep, and physical activity. We'll add a few other conditions. Interestingly, when our advisor, Peter Gabriel, was visiting recently, he said, team, this is really good, but when you fill in the blanks, when I want to fall asleep, relax, I listen to X, but you're missing one. And I said, which one? He said, when I want to feel sexy. Okay, now that's obviously, if many of you say that we should add that one, we'll do that, and we can track that as well. So by going to this URL at any point, and if you have an example of a song that has worked for you, you can share it. And you can see I'm a Max Richter fan. Max Richter wrote a piece of music 8 hours long to sleep in. There's excerpts available. And so when I want to fall asleep, I listen to Path 5 Delta from Max Richter's Sleep. And then we ask that everyone, to the extent that you feel comfortable, share the song that you have recommended for this functional purpose so that others hear and we collect this data set. Over time, we'll share the results with you as long as we don't ask for any identifying information, but if you leave us your email, we will contact you once we're done. In addition to working with the top scientists, we've also partnered with world-leading musicians, Esa Pekka Salonen of London Philharmonia Orchestra, Gabriel, John Hopkins, and St. Vincent, Annie Clark. And with that, I'd like to thank you for your attention and especially for your recommendations. Your considered thoughts on what music has worked will help us build this data set and develop music as medicine. Thank you.
Fantastic. Thank you, Marko. I wonder, do we have a question for Marko in the audience? Any question? We have time for one. There's one right at the back. I'm going to walk over to you.
Hi, thanks. That was a really interesting talk. I've been using music for a long time for healing and for various things. I suffered from migraines when I was a kid, and I used to listen to Cat Stevens, and that was the only thing that would sort of chill it out. Didn't matter how I medicated. But anyway, I'm wondering if I could find out more about participating in your program and being a case study or something like that, if you're looking for volunteers.
Thank you. The best way to do that is to sign up on the site by email. If you read our blog, we've essentially been, for the last year, highlighting all the top science across the globe and the top scientists working on different conditions. And you can read about it on the blog. We've been cataloging that. Also, let us know if there's some research we have missed. Our point is to be firmly in between the scientific community and the musicians to discover this medicinal use.
The Mozart effect. You know the Mozart effect?
Yes. Many problematic interpretations of that. So,
brilliant. One more question? No?
Yes, one. Okay.
Hi, I'm just wondering what you'll be doing, if anything, to try to get a really broad sense, being as there is some research about the cultural differences in, say, dissonance and so on. So are you really going to go out there with the collecting information?
So very good question. Related to the cultural differences, we actually think that the more operative differences from the health point of view are actually on the individual level. But we won't know until we have enough scale and enough global reach and different music communities, but our understanding is that both the response to different acoustic properties and their ranges, like rhythm, is affected individually. Then, of course, we have individual preference, all the historicity with music, what have we known, but then the response to the acoustic properties is also personalized. And finally, your heartbeat and your heart rate right now is different from the person next to you and the person next to you. It's different from me. It's come from a certain place. So what we would play you next is a question of your current physiology as well, in a sense of biofeedback. And therefore, what we think of what we're doing essentially is building a biometric music recommendation engine. What is the playlist tuned to your body, given who you are, your history with music, your personal response to music, and your current state?
Thank you very much, Marko. That was really brilliant and refreshing.
Thank you.
A warm round of applause.